If you spent time at the beach over the last few days, you likely saw power high tide conditions.
Some residents say it is one sign of a wet winter ahead. News Channel 3 senior reporter John Palmateri joins us live. And John, even though it's been sunny, there are strong indicators coming to the surface.
And I've been paying close attention to our First Alert Weather Center. For weeks, we have been hearing about some of these indicators about strong ocean activity that's very likely, or strong rain patterns that are very likely in the weeks ahead. And I talked to people on the waterfront today in Santa Barbara, and they are also convinced we're in for some wet weather, and they are preparing.
Waves pounding the Santa Barbara seawall have been a wake-up call for many residents who are seeing what they believe is the change in weather that may begin a stronger than normal winter season ahead.
I'm hoping it sticks around for a while, and this is just the start of our El Nino.
This comes after a warm water pattern.
The temperature change was really everything. I mean, it started with the hammerheads, and it started with all the different fish out in the water. And as surfers, we're out there, and you can kind of smell it, you can feel it.
In the next couple of days, efforts to keep the sometimes sand-clogged harbor entrance open will begin. Without it, over 1,000 boats could be sand-trapped inside.
Once these long dredge pipes here on West Beach are connected, they'll take sandy water from the dredge out in the harbor down to East Beach. This is a fully funded operation, and the City Waterfront Department says it'll be operational December 2nd through the 24th.
Residents who have seen heavy surf, rough weather, and flooding before are gearing up, not just near the coastline, but also out on the roads.
You know, it's not necessarily you're driving, it's everybody else's driving. You know, people just don't slow down when it's raining. People are bad enough drivers just on their own with not paying attention.
Long timers remember vicious storms, whether the pattern was El Nino or just big powerful system.
Mentally, just so, I mean, it's kind of like, it's not our first rodeo with that. You know, but
you remember the 1982
Hurricane Aliva, and I remember that pretty vividly, being 12, you know, but it ripped our town apart.
Oh, it sure did. As a matter of fact, we lost some of the waterfront. We lost a pier at that time. It was really devastating. Some cities like Goleta, by the way, are offering sandbags 7 days a week at two fire stations during daylight hours. Reporting live from the Santa Barbara waterfront, I'm John Palmateri, News Channel 3.